Assalamu alaikum, gentlemen. We start our program with the recitation of Holy Quran, and I'll invite Kashif from ICAP to recite few verses from the Holy Quran. Mr. Kashif, please.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Qul huwallahu ahad. Allahus samad. لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد صدق الله العظيم.
جزاك الله كاشف. On behalf of the Session Agent Committee of ICAP, I would take this opportunity to welcome you all in the seminar. The topic of the seminar is Issues and Challenges of Labor Laws Application in the Post-18th Constitutional Amendment Scenario. And for this seminar, we have invited a very thorough gentleman and a very famous person, Mr. Fazlul Kareem Siddiqui. I think he needs no introduction, but again, it's a privilege for introducing him to the audience. Mr. Siddiqui has done his master's in sociology from Dhaka University, then master's in business administration from IB Karachi, master's in law from SM Law Karachi, and diploma in journalism from Dhaka University. He is a certified corporate director from the Institute of Directors, Mumbai. He has 34 years of HR professional experience as head of HR in Pakistan's two largest electronic and automobile manufacturing companies. His last assignment was that of Director Human Resources, Material Operations and Progressive Manufacturing at Hinopak Motors Limited. Transforming organizations, culture, synthesizing Japanese management practices into the culture of Pakistani organizations are among the added special areas of his accomplishments. Around 20 years of professional training career in leadership, management, labor laws, CSR, quality, productivity, and system management, conducting over 200 workshops within and outside the country, including India, Ethiopia, UAE, Kenya, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Nepal, UK and USA. He is also a visiting faculty for over 20 years at leading business schools and universities of Pakistan. He is an author of more than 50 articles and 3 books relating HR and IR reflections, productivity and national legislation on international labor standards. Currently, he is the chief executive of the Institute of Leadership Development, and he's also the member of Managing Committee of Employers Federation of Pakistan. With these words, gentlemen, please put your hands together to welcome Mr. Fazlul Kareem Siddiqui. Ji, caller mic bilkul hai. I'd like to share with you that we'll have the break around about 6 o'clock for the Maghrib prayer for 15 to 20 minutes, then we'll continue the session. And as far as the question answer is concerned, we'll have an exclusive session at the end of the seminar. But if you'd like to raise any question, you can do so. Thank you.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. It's indeed a proud privilege and honor for me to be able to interact with this galaxy of my very dear close friends, associates, colleagues, and professional managers who are here at the invitation of the Institute. And I'm feeling very odd standing here. Do you mind if I come there? Thank you, because I think I can move around. Shada had provided me that flexibility. I will change the slides if necessary as and when I... Okay, so let us first of all come to the background of today's meeting. But before I do that, it may take a few seconds by each one of you to give me a very brief introduction, the organization you come from. Very quick, okay? Maybe a few seconds, everybody can share, and maybe you would also be able to interact, sir, very quickly. Great, sir. Great, sir. 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 From then. Sir. Family? Yeah, yeah. Sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Our good friends, yes, sir. Jiyap. And who doesn't know Shada? Great. So, thank you very much. We are here to talk about the topic that you can see right on the screen. I think any discussion on this subject would be incomplete if we try to understand the background of what is to be discussed this afternoon. And what is the background of the 18th Amendment in the Constitution and its impact on labor laws and labor welfare? I think if we were to scan the background, at least three or four things are very important for us to keep in mind and why and how and what is going to happen after the constitutional amendment. But before constitutional amendment, what was happening is no less an important paradox for us to understand, to explain and understand the delicacies of the way forward.